Hello everyone, today in this video I will talk about the bone meal plant disease. This is the part 4 of my video series on bleeding disorder. Before telling about the disease, you should know what is von Willebrand factor and what is the action of von Willebrand factor. So von Willebrand factor is large multimeric glycoprotein which is synthesized in megakaryocyte and endothelial cell and is stored in Willebrand pellet bodies in endothelial cell and alpha granules in platelets. Function of von Willebrand factor. First, von Willebrand factor serve to tether the platelet to injured subendothelium by binding site for platelet and for collagen. So in this picture you can see after vascular injury there is conformational changes in von Willebrand factor which facilitates its ability to bind the platelet through a binding site on platelet glycoprotein 1b. This enables the von Willebrand factor to recruit the platelet to the site of clot formation. So this part is depend on the high molecular weight multimer form of von Willebrand factor. Now the second function is von Willebrand factor serves as a carrier protein for factor 8 and protecting the factor 8 from degradation in plasma. Without von Willebrand factor, half life of factor 8 reduced from 12 to 24 hours to 2 to 4 hours only. So this is the second most important function of von Willebrand factor. Now what happens without von Willebrand factor? Platelets are not targeted to area of endothelial damage, so it will lead to the insufficient formation of platelet plaque and fibrin clot, and secondary deficiency of factor 8 will be there because of accelerated clearance of the factor 8, because we know half life of factor 8 will be reduced from 12 to 24 hours to only 2 to 4 hours without von Willebrand factor. So patient will develop the von Willebrand disease, which is the most common hereditary bleeding disorder. Its incidence are 1 to 2% in whole population, and it is caused by defect in von Willebrand factor, either qualitative or quantitative. Now the classification of von Willebrand disease, it is classified into three types, type 1, 2 and 3. Type 1 and 3 are quantitative defect, while the type 2 is the qualitative defect. In type 1, partial deficiency of von Willebrand factor present, while in type 3, complete quantitative deficiency of von Willebrand factor is present. In type 2, qualitative abnormal variant of von Willebrand factor is present. Type 1 is the most common and it is present in 60 to 80%. In this, patient will have the mild bleeding manifestations. While in the type 3, it is the rarest, present in less than 5%, but this bleeding manifestation will be severe because complete deficiency of von Willebrand factor is there. It resembles the severe hemophilia A. In type 2, moderate bleeding manifestations will be there. Type 1 and 2 are autosomal dominant, while the type 3 is autosomal recessive. So all von Willebrand disease are autosomal dominant except type 3. Type 2 is further classified into 4 subtypes, type 2A, 2B, 2M and 2N. 2A, in this absence of high molecular weight von Willebrand factor multimer. In type 2B, hyperactive von Willebrand factor and its increased affinity for the platelet glycoprotein 1B. In 2M, reduction of the platelet binding function of von Willebrand factor. Type 2B and 2M are the opposite of each other. In type 2N, reduction of factor 8 binding function of von Willebrand factor. So this is the subtypes of type 2. I will tell you the details of all these subtypes. What investigation you will plan when you are suspecting the von Willebrand disease?
As we know, in the absence of von Willebrand factor, platelets will not be able to attach to the subendothelium damaged sites. So, in this, platelet counts, bleeding time will be prolonged and PFA will be altered. And now the second function of von Willebrand factor, it acts as a carrier protein for factor 8. So, in the absence of this, factor 8 concentrate will be affected and APTT will be prolonged. So, we will plan these investigations. Now, we have to see the von Willebrand factor antigen level, multimer distribution level, von Willebrand factor erythrocytin, cofactor activity, and low dose erythrocytin induced platelet aggregation test. So, all these investigations we will plan when we are suspecting the von Willebrand disease. Now I will tell you the result of all these investigations according to the type of von Willebrand disease. So in type 1, when you will go for all these investigations, you will find the decreased von Willebrand factor antigen level. This level will be less than 30 international unit per DL. It is for making the diagnosis of von Willebrand disease. Von Willebrand factor activity, decreased erythrocytin cofactor activity will be reduced. While there will be normal von Willebrand factor multimers level, there will be normal or mildly decreased factor 8 concentrate and normal platelet count, bleeding time and APTT will be in type 1. Whenever we are performing the von Willebrand factor antigen assay, we should keep in mind that there are various external factors which can influence the von Willebrand factor level. Example, it can be seen in the people with the blood group O. Stress, exercise, pregnancy all increase the von Willebrand factor level, and hypothyroidism and few medications, example valproic acid, decrease the von Willebrand factor level. So whenever we are performing the von Willebrand factor antigen level and you are having the strong suspicious about this disease, you have to repeat the test after a month to rule out or to confirm the diagnosis. Now in type 2A, there will be absence of high molecular weight von Willebrand factor multimers. It is the most common variant of type 2 and it accounts for 10% of von Willebrand disease cases. When you will go for the investigation, you will find that decreased von Willebrand factor antigen level will be there. There is a defect in von Willebrand factor multimerization. So there will be loss of high molecular weight multimer and decrease von Willebrand factor activity in terms of platelet binding, while action for the as a carrier protein for the factor 8 concentrate will be normal. So in this, when you will go for the APTT and factor 8 concentrate, it will be normal in type 2A. Platelet counts will be normal. In type 2B, there is a gain of function mutation. So, there is increased ability of von Willebrand factor to bind the platelet. This leads to the increased clearance of both von Willebrand factor and platelets from the circulation. So, patient will have the deficiency of both von Willebrand factor and platelets from the circulation. And this will lead to the loss of high molecular weight multimer and decrease of von Willebrand factor activity. For the investigation in type 2B, you will find the increased platelet binding and increased response to even low dose erythrocytin on the platelet aggregation LD-RIPA. In normal person, when you will go for the LD-RIPA, there will be no or mild platelet aggregation. While in patient of the type 2B von Willebrand disease, you will find that increased response to the low dose erythrocytin on platelet aggregation. So this is very specific test for the type 2B. And thrombocytopenia may be present in the type 2B, but it is not always present. And this is the one of the differential diagnosis for the non-immune type of thrombocytopenia, in which the consumption is increased, destruction is increased. Now in type 2M, there will be a reduction of platelet binding function of von Willebrand factor. This is just opposite of the type 2B. In type 2B, there is an increased binding function, platelet binding function of von Willebrand factor. While in type 2M, there is a reduction of platelet binding function of von Willebrand factor. While the binding of von Willebrand factor to the factor 8 will remain normal in type 2M. So in type 2A, 2B and 2M, in all three, binding of this protein to factor 8 remains normal. It is affected only in type 2N. So when you will go for the investigation, you will find that either decrease or normal von Willebrand factor antigen level, markedly decrease erythrocytin cofactor activity. There will be normal factor 8 concentration and normal platelet count, but bleeding time will be increased. Now type 2M. In this reduction of factor 8 binding by the von Willebrand factor, so patient will present as a hemophilia. It is also known as autosomal hemophilia. When you will go for the investigation, you will find that decrease on normal von Willebrand factor antigen level, decrease on normal erythrocytin cofactor activity, because the action of the von Willebrand factor for the platelet binding will remain normal. Decrease factor 8 concentration and prolonged APTT will be in this condition, and normal platelet count, bleeding time and platelet function analyzer. Now type 3. In type 3, there will be complete deficiency of von Willebrand factor. So when you will go for the antigen assay, you will find the absent von Willebrand factor antigen level, very low factor 8, less than 10 international unit per dl, and absent erythrocytin cofactor activity, because this is a quantitative defect, and in this complete deficiency of von Willebrand factor is there. So all the functions of von Willebrand factor will be affected. And so prolonged APTT, decreased factor 8 concentrate, and it can be even only 1-3%. Platelet counts will be normal, but markedly increased bleeding time and altered PFA. There is a one variety, pseudo von Willebrand factor. It is also known as platelet type von Willebrand factor. It is in this the converse abnormality of the type 2B von Willebrand disease. In type 2B von Willebrand disease, as we had discussed, that there will be a gain of function mutation of the platelet binding site of von Willebrand factor. While in the pseudo von Willebrand disease, there is a mutation in platelet glycoprotein 1B receptor. It causes the spontaneous binding to the von Willebrand factor. And patient will also present with the decreased von Willebrand factor activity. Patient will have the thrombocytopenia, increased platelet bindings will be there, and increased response to the low dose erythrocytin on platelet aggregation. So LD-RIPA test is specific for the type 2B von Willebrand disease and also for the pseudo von Willebrand disease. So in this table, you can compare the old types of von Willebrand disease and you can see the investigation. So antigen level will be reduced in all the types except in type 2N. It will be normal or decrease in type 2N, and it is totally absent in type 3. And von Willebrand factor erythrocytin cofactor activity will be reduced in type 1. It is normal or slightly reduced in type 2N, while it is totally absent in type 3 and severely affected in type 2A, 2B and 2N. So when you will go for the antigen level and erythrocytin cofactor activity, you will find that antigen level is not significantly affected in type 2, but its activity is significantly affected because it is a qualitative defect. When you will go for the factor 8th level, it is reduced in type 3 and type 2N, while it will be normal in other types. When you will go for the multimer distribution level, it will be normal in type 1 and it will be absent in type 3. While loss of high molecular weight multimer is characteristic of type 2N and 2V and completely absent in type 3. When you will go for the low dose Rystrosetin induced platelet aggregation, you will find that it is characteristically positive or prolonged in type 2B only, while it is absent. With the low dose of Rystrosetin, platelet will not be aggregated in all other types and in normal subset. Now, how will you treat the von Willebrand disease? There are three modality of treatments. Either we can give the desmopressin, it will induce the release of von Willebrand factor from the endothelial cell, or we can give the plasma derived von Willebrand factor concentrate that also contain the factor 8, or we can give the antifibrinolytics. So in this table you can see how to give the and in which type you will give the which treatment. So desmopressin is effective in type 1 and sometime in type 2 also, but we have to be very careful because we know in type 1 there is a mild deficiency of von Willebrand factor. So desmopressin will help into the release of von Willebrand factor. It is given IV or intranasal. Dose is 0.3 microgram per kilogram IV or intranasally one spray for the less than 50 kg weight and two spray for the more than 50 kg weight. And we have to give the von Willebrand factor concentrate in type 3, type 2 and severe type 1 also when there is a type 1 clearance defect. And it is given IV 40 to 60 Rystrosetin cofactor activity unit per kg. Antifibrinolytic therapy when there is a mucosal bleeding, it is useful in all types of von Willebrand disease, IV or orally. In this, aminocaproic acid 100 mg per kilogram oral loading dose followed by 50 mg per kilogram QID. Tranexamic acid can be given 1300 mg orally divided into TDS doses for 5 days. Now I will tell you in short blood vessels disorder. I will not go into the details of blood vessel disorder as this is the fourth part of bleeding disorder. Blood vessel disorder, either it is congenital or acquired in congenital, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia. This is also known as Osler-Rendu-Weber disease, and in acquired causes of either it can be seen in the scurvy patient because generally gums bleeding and bleeding from the other mucosal sites can be seen in the scurvy, and in severe acute malnourished baby also prolonged steroid use or in Cushing disease also bleeding manifestation can be seen. Henoch-Schönlein purpura, this is the most common vasculitis in children and in uremic patient and in SLE. I will tell you in short about the Henoch-Schönlein purpura. This is the most common vasculitis in children. 90% HSP cases occur between 3 to 10 years age group. When we see for the male to female ratio, it is around 1.2:1.8:1. It is more common in winter and spring season. It is also known as IgA vasculitis or anaphylactoid purpura or purpura rheumatic. Characterized by the purpuric rashes, pateki, palpable purpura over the lower extremities and buttocks. In this patient will have the arthritis also, abdominal pain and renal involvement is also seen in this. When you will go for the investigation, you will find that all the coagulation studies and the platelets are normal. And even you will find that thrombocytosis, leukocytosis and raised ESR is there. When you will go for the IgA and IgM concentration, it will be raised in 50% patients. Anticardiolipin and antiphospholipid antibody can be positive. And for the definitive diagnosis, you have to go for the biopsy, and in all tissue immunofluorescence, you will identify that Ig deposition in the wall of small vessels and accompanied by the deposition of C3 fibrin and IgM. treatment is corticosteroid, either orally or injectable. Orally, we can give the prednisolone 1 to 2 mg per kilogram per day. And even we can go for the injectable methylprednisolone, which is given 30 mg per kilogram per day continuously for the 3 days, and then weekly or twice weekly we can repeat this. If patient is having the thrombotic events, then aspirin. And if the patient is having rheumatoid nodules, then colchicine therapy should be given. Thank you.